أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ثم الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه الأخيار، أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to us all once again to our القراءة الراشدة lessons in Arabic proficiency. It's been a long break. It's been a very long break, but I'm more glad for the fact that we didn't break completely from every lesson. For the period of the Ramadan, we decided to do something on poems specifically. So we selected popular poems, poems that are very interesting and cool, and then we explained them. That made the 30 episode Ramadan Golden Wear series. So still we were in contact with the language. What I do not like is that we break away from the language for a very long while. When you are studying language and you break away for a long while, those that you know already keep flying out before you realize you've lost almost everything. And so we try to always keep up. But then we've gone a very long break from this particular lesson. And so we are starting again. We are continuing our Al-Qira'at al-Rashida lessons from the next topic, Al-Haninu ila al-Shahadati. Al-Haninu ila al-Shahadati, we've already explained that in the previous lesson, which was also Al-Haninu ila al-Shahadati. You can run back quickly to check. That was also Al-Haninu ila al-Shahadati, part one. And we discussed that. So if you've not seen it, you just go back quickly and then pick from there. So today we are picking Al-Haninu ila al-Shahadati again, but then part two. We are doing the part two today. Okay, Al-Haninu again is nostalgia, the feeling of nostalgia, feeling nostalgic towards something, desiring for something, longing for something. And Al-Shahada is martyrdom. That is, you die in the course of, in a good cause. You die whilst fighting for, to save people. You die in the course of protecting the religion. In such a way, we say, he died a martyr. Aywa, that is what we say in Arabic, mata shahidan. Shahidan, mata shahidan. So when we say al-haninu ila shahadati, what we mean is that longingness or nostalgia towards martyrdom. Okay, so you realize the happenings in Israel and the happenings between Israel and Gaza recently, you would see that when you look at the videos from Gaza, there is one that was very popular. This young guy sitting down with a friend or brother of his dead, and he was kind of happy. And when he was interviewed, he said, the brother has died shaheed and he is still here. So he's finding himself like a loser. So this thing is in the Arabs that when you die a shaheed, you've actually ended your world war. And so they have the desire towards it. Okay. He says, وَلَمَّا خَرَجَ. Okay, so the wahye being a conjunction, one seeing this one can easily tell that, oh, some story has come before. Or something has come before. Before you start a story and you say end, oh, then there is something. So let me take you back again. You see something here. You realize that this story started with lamma without wa, because this is the beginning of the al-haninu ila shahada. This is the first story from in that regards. So you realize that it didn't start with end. It started right away. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to go out for the fight of Badr. Okay, now after telling us that story, Badr was one campaign or one fight that they went for. So when he's about telling us the other story, he brings a conjunction to tell us that it is a series of story. This is part one, this is part two. So he's joining them. He says, وَلَمَّا خَرَجَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِلَىٰ أُحُدٍ. And when Lama, as I've already explained, is when. And when the Messenger of Allah, Kharaja, went out, ila Uhudin, to Uhud. Uhud is the name of a mountain. Jabal Uhud. Okay, so when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went, and Uhud, because of the mountain, the place is called Uhud. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Uhud, likitali Quraishin, to fight the people of Quraysh, the people from Mecca, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Uhud to meet them in that fight. Kharaja ma'ahu min al-Madinati, he has went to Medina. When they were in Mecca, they were persecuted and they were pursued, and they went to Medina. And so from Medina, he had a lot of followers. And now these people from Mecca, the people from Quraysh, heard that he is gathering a lot of crowd there. So let us meet him out and fight him. So they scheduled for this fight, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam met them at Uhud. Okay. So he says, when he went out, likital, kital is a fight between two, from the verb qatala. Qatala, the verbal now is two. We have muqatala, muqatalatun, a fight between two people. Or kital, same meaning, a fight between two people. So the meter fa'ala has two verbal noun formula. You either have it from fa'ala can give you the verbal noun fi'al or mufa'ala. Okay. So he says, when he went out to Uhud to fight the Quraysh, kharaja ma'ahu min al-madinati gilmanun yuhibbuna al-jihad fi sabilillah. Let's look at something. When, as we've already done some grammar, we've done al-jumla al-fi'liyya, and you've seen how jumla fi'liyya goes, a verbal sentence. When you have the verb, you should be expecting the doer of the verb. So you can say that this person did this action. So the moment we've seen kharaja went out, ma'ahu, with him, min al-madinati, from Medina, gilmanun. So you come to see a noun here with dhamma. So we say that this noun is the doer of the verb kharaja. And gilman is the plural of gulam. Gulam, which is a young boy. So he says, kharaja ma'ahu min al-madinati gilmanun. So some two young boys, or some young boys, followed him, went out with him. And these young boys were from Medina, min al-Madina. Ay kharaja gilmanun min al-Madinati ma'ahu. Two young boys, or a group of young boys. When we say gilman, we mean a young boys. Some young boys went out with him from Medina. And these young boys, it describes them here. It says, yuhibbun al-jihada fi sabilillah. They love to struggle in the cause of Allah. Al-jihad is struggle, from the verb jahada. So you can see that jahada, to strive with, to struggle. And the verbal noun, listen, jihad, on the meter fi'al. I just told you that when you have a verb fa'ala, the verbal noun can come fi'al or mufa'ala. So here we have jahada, and then the verbal noun jihad. Okay. So he says, yuhibbun al-jihad, they love to strive fi sabilillah, in the cause of Allah, or in the path of Allah. Sabil is path. Okay. Wa kanu sigaran, and they were little, they were young. Sigar, they were young. Lam yatajawazu, tajawaza, the verb tajawaza, to cross something. Jawaza al-had. Jawazta al-had. If I tell you jawazta al-had hazihi al-marra, you cross the limit this time around. Jawazta al-had hazihi al-marra. Or tajawazta al-had. So if he says, lam yatajawazu al-khamisata asharata min umrihim. Al-khamisata al-ashara, 15. Lam yatajawazu, they have not crossed or passed 15 min umrihim, from their age. That is literal. But what it means is that they have not reached or passed, they've not passed 15 years. So they are around 15, 14 thereabout. Again, kharaja ma'ahu min al-madinati ghilmanun yuhibbun al-jihad. Some youth, little boys, went out from Medina with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yuhibbun al-jihad. They loved to strive fi sabilillah, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa kanu sigaran, and they were young. Lam yatajawazu, they have not crossed al-khamisata asharata min umrihim, 15 years. They hadn't crossed 15 years. So they were at most 15 years. فَرَدَّهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ. رَدَّ, to turn someone back. I think we saw this in the previous Al-Haninu ila al-Watan, Al-Haninu ila al-Shahada, part 1. رَدَّ, to retain something. So you can say, تَصَلْتُ عَلَيْهِ أو اتَّصَلْتُ بِهِ وَلَمْ يَرُدُّ وَلَمْ يَرُدُّ عَلَيَّ اتَّصَلْتُ بِهِ وَلَمْ يَرُدُّ عَلَيَّ. Some Arabs say اتصلت عليه, I knew اتصلت به, I contacted him, ولم يرد عليه, and he didn't respond. But from some Libyans I've heard اتصل عليه, اتصلت عليك, using على instead of be. So both sound okay, but اتصلت به is what I've really seen in classical. He says لم يتجاوزوا الخامسة عشرة من عمرهم. And due to that, فَرَدَّهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Due to that, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked them to return. He bounds them back. لِأَنَّهُمْ سِغَارٌ, because they are small. لَمْ يَبْلُغُوا, they have not reached سِنَّ الْكِتَالِ, the age of fight. They've not reached the age that they will be allowed to fight. فَيَكُونُونَ كَلْمَتَا, and so due to that, يَكُونُونَ, they will be like kelmata, they will be like, mata is the provisions one carries along when he's traveling. When you are traveling abroad, this your luggages, they are called mata. And you know how it's stressful when you have a lot of luggages with you. When you have a lot of luggage with you, how it's really stressful. So he says, these little boys, they've not reached the age of fighting. So if they should follow, they will be like mata, they will be like luggage. وَيَشْغُلُونَ الْكِبَارَ, and they will get وَيَشْغُلُونَ الْكِبَارَ أَيْضًا, and they will busy the elderly ones also. They will be like luggage, they will have no use for us, and also they will also get the elderly ones busy. How? يُرَاقِبُونَهُمْ, because the elderly ones have to be watching over them. رَاقَبَ, to watch over something. So somebody, security is called haris or muraqib. An accountant in a firm or in a workplace, you hear al-muraqibul mali, financial controller. Al-muraqibul mali, financial controller, almost like the accountant in the workplace. So he says wayashghuluna al-kibara aidan, they will get the elderly ones busy. Yuraqibunahum, they will be watching them. وَيَحْرِسُونَهُمْ, and protecting them. Harasa, to protect. So we call the Haris, the security, the guard. Okay. وَكَانَ فِي هَؤُلَاءِ الْغِلْمَانِ وَلَدٌ, and among these youth, little boys, there was a boy. كَانَ فِيهِمْ وَلَدٌ. كَانَ فِي هَؤُلَاءِ الْغِلْمَانِ وَلَدٌ. There was a boy among them. إِسْمُهُ رَافِعٌ. اسمه رافع بن خديج. The boy's name is رافع, the son of خديج. وهو دون الخامسة عشرة من سنه. Okay. So you see the expression لم يتجاوزوا الخامسة عشرة من عمرهم. This is a similar expression with different vocabularies. It says وهو, and this particular boy رافع, Duna, he is below. Duna, among his meaning, is below. I've already said, if I say فسيدونك القمامة. دونك الكمامة. دونك الكمامة. Have, that means have this mask. If I say دونك الماء. دونك الماء. That is take this water. دونك الماء. But if I tell you الماء, الماء دون الطاولة. The water is below the table. This is from the verb dana. When we say dana, to come close and go like that, go down. Dana lahu. If you say dana lahu, like has a rajulu dhu akhlaq. This man has good characters. Fadana lahu jami'u sukkan al-watan. And so everybody in the nation, sukkan al-watan, the people of the nation, the populace, they've submitted to him. Dana lahu. So duna, to be below, it has that meaning. Duna has to be behind. Okay, it has a lot of meaning, but here it means below. So if it says wahua duna al-khamisata asharata min sinnihi, he is below 15 years. Literally, he is below 15 from his age. So his age is below 15, 14 downwards. وَكَانَ يَتَطَاوَلُ مِنْ شِدَّةِ الشَّوْقِ. A shawq is ardent desire, strong desire. If you follow the Golden Way series, we've met shawq a lot. It says, وَكَانَ يَتَطَاوَلُ. تَطَاوَلَ is two meanings here that we will pick. When we say تَطَاوَلَ عَلَى is to oppress somebody. If I say تَطَاوَلَ عَلَيَّ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, this man oppressed me. He was over me. He was pressing me with stuff and trying to bully me. تَطَاوَلَ عَلَيَّ. Okay. But this is not the case. تَطَاوَلَ again is to be acting daring. To be there and be acting like you are also somebody. You know when people describe you to be weak for a long time and you want to prove yourself, you'll be acting like somewhat stubborn or arrogant. That is the meaning you should keep here. وَكَانَ يَتَطَاوَلُ مِنْ شِدَّةِ الشَّوْكِ. So he was acting to show himself due to strong, the severity of his longingness to follow them to fight. Okay. So you can see this small boy around 14 years standing in the crowd acting. And there is something you should note. Their ages then wasn't like now. So in their history, you see between the age of a father and son, almost like 10 years, 11 years, 12 years. If you should read Sirah and you should read about this Sahaba a lot closely, you realize that their ages is not like us here. Now somebody between the age of a father and a son, you can see 25 years, 30 years, like that. But then you could see between the father and son, like 10 years, 11 years, 12 years, 15 years, thereabout. So a lot was happening. So there is this a whole different atmosphere that you should picture. When you are learning these stories, you should picture a whole different atmosphere, society. Okay. So as this boy, Rafi'u, was there, Rafi'u Afwan, was there showing himself, he was doing this, liyazunna, so that people, liyazunna nasu, so that people would think, annahu kabirun, that he is big. قَدْ بَلَغَ سِنَّ الْقِتَالِ, he has reached the age of fighting. فَلَا يُفْتَنُ لِصِغَرِ سِنِّهِ وَضَعْفِهِ, and so people will not be able to realize صِغَرِ سِنِّهِ, the smallness of his age, وَضَعْفِهِ, and his weakness. What we are picking here is يُفْتَنُ لِ. When we have the verb فَطِنَ لِ, if I say فَطِنَ لَهُ, he has realized, he has come of knowledge of some particular issue. So if I say fatwina rajulu lil amru, fatwina rajulu lil amri, the man has realized the issue, the man has gotten knowledge of the issue, ay fatwina lahu. Okay. Fatina itself is to be smart. But when you have it, fortunately, then you know that it comes with to know. Ay alima wa fahima. Okay. Fala yuftanu li shigari sinnihi wa da'fi, so that the smallness of his age and his weakness wouldn't be realized, wouldn't be seen. Okay. Walakin Rasulallahi, and due to lakinna, Rasulu came Rasula with fatha here, because of lakinna. You see that in inna wa akhwataha. You see that we said inna, anna, lakinna, ka'anna, layta, la'alla. When they come, the noun that comes after them takes fatha. So when we read walakinna Rasulallahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam raddahu, but after all this sketch that he was doing, after all these tiles, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam knew it, and so he sent him back raddahu li'annahu arafa annahu saghirun. Look at it here. Ay li'annahu fatina lahu annahu saghirun, li'annahu fatina annahu saghirun, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam knew that he was small. Ay arafa annahu saghirun. So you realize that arafa here comes to explain the fatina. Okay, so the Prophet, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam knew he was young, he sent him away that he cannot fight. Okay. Wa annahu yatatawalu, and that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sent him away because he realized he is small, and that he is just trying to show off. He's just trying to raise himself to be seen as somebody who is full of age and strength. Okay. Fashafa'a lahu abuhu, and so his father shafa'a lahu, to intercede for. Okay. So if I say shafa'atu laka inda al-mudir, you do something bad, and so you come to me and say ya ridwan min fadlik uridu shafa'ataka inda al-mudir, laqad akhta'tu indahu. Like you come to me and say, oh Ridwan, I need your shafa'a, I need your intercession, I need you to intermediate for me with the head, the mudir, because I've wronged the mudir. Okay, and so fa ashfa'u laka inda al-mudir, and so I will intercede for you with the mudir. So shafa'ali, to intercede for. So here we read fa shafa'a lahu abuhu, and so his father interceded for him. Wa qala ya rasulallah, and the father said ya rasulallah. And when ya comes, and a name that is mudaf and mudaf ilay, a possessive construction, like ya abdallahi, ya ibn ridwani, in that case the noun that comes first in the possessive construction takes fatha. So when you hear ya and you hear rasulullah, it's wrong. It's supposed to be ya rasulallahi, oh messenger of Allah. Innabni, indeed my son rafi'an, my son rafi', ramin, is a ramin, somebody who throws arrows, he knows how to throw arrow. I from the verb rama, yermi, and the ramin is the fa'il, the doer. So you have it arami. Let's take this here. This noun here is arami. When it has alif and lam here, the yai shows. Alif and lam before the ra, you have arami with yai. Like al-qadi, al-madi. All of these, when you take away the alif and lam, the yai also goes. So you have madin, fa'ilun madin. Then you hear qadin. Then you hear ramin, like that. So names that end with yai like that, when the alif and lam is not there, the name, the yai goes away. Okay. So the father told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that my son is a shooter, he shoots the arrows. فَأَذِّنَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, and so the messenger of Allah permitted him, he gave him permission. Okay. Let's move ourselves here. Okay, I think you're good. And so فَفَرِحَ رَافِعٌ كَثِيرًا, and Rafi got very excited. Lama adhina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam permitted when he gave permission. وَخَرَجَ مَعَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ And Rafa went out with the Mujahideen, those who went out for the jihad. They are called the Mujahideen. وَهُوَ أَكْثَرُ سُرُورًا And he was more happy or more happier, if that is, مِنْ غِلْمَانٍ He was more happier than small boys يَخْرُجُونَ إِلَى الْمُصَلَّى who go out to the praying field. Al-Musalla is wherever prayer is said. يوم العيد on the day of Eid في لباس جديد in a new dress. You know when little boys are dressed beautifully in new dresses and they are going for Eid, that happiness. He said that when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam permitted Rafa, he was more happy than Kays in this situation. Okay. And he says, وكان ولد آخر اسمه سمرة بن جندب في سن رافع. There was also a boy, another boy, ولد آخر, another boy, اسمه سمرة بن جندب. His name is Samura, the son of Jundub. في سن رافع. He was the same age or around the age of رافع. When you hear في سنه, he is in the same class of age with him. في سن رافع أي في نفس السن أو قريبا إليه. We say they are أتراب, they are colleagues of age. فعرض على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد رافع and this boy was presented to the messenger of Allah بعد رافع after رافع was permitted. فرده رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لصغره أيضا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent him back due to the smallness of his age, due to how young he is. فقال سمرة and سمرة told said سمرة said لقد أجزت رافعا أجزت أي أجازة from the verb أجازة to permit لقد أجزت Rafi'an, you had permitted Rafi, waradattani, and you have sent me away. Walau sara'tuhu, la sara'tuhu. Let's stand here a bit. Sara'a, to fight with, to have a tussle with, to have this grudge with. That is sara'a. That is the verb. And the verbal noun, If you remember again, I have told you the verb, if it is on the meter, fa'ala, the verbal noun can come fi'al, fi'al, like jahada, jihad, qatala, qital. And it can also come mufa'ala, such that if you have a verb like jahada, you say mujahada, or if you have a verb like qatala, you say muqatala, that is the fight, the noun. From the verb. So a verb like sara'a, to have a tussle with, to have a grudge with, we cook the verbal now by saying sira', that is fi'al, sira'un, or musara'a. You see, we've gotten the two, fi'al, which is sira', and then we have musara'a, which is Mufa'ala. You can form the verbal noun in these two cases. Okay. And then he says, وَلَوْ سَرَعْتُهُ If I should fight with him, لَسَرَعْتُهُ I want us to note this morphology here. Morphology is very, very important. If I should fight with him, سَرَعَ is to fight with. But سَرَعَ is to put somebody down, to defeat somebody. So you have a مُسَرَعَ And then, if you are able to be the one sora'a, doing the sora'a, you are the one putting the person down. So if I say, ra'aytu al-musara'ata bayna, or ra'aytu musara'atan, I saw a fight, bayna al-waladi wal-binti, between the girl and, between the boy and the girl. Ra'aytu musara'atan bayna. Let's make it waladin nakira. Bayna waladin, I saw a fight between a boy, wabintin, and a girl. فصارعت البنت الولد. And the girl put the boy down. She defeated the boy. Get the difference between sara'a, which is to fight with, but sara'a is to defeat somebody, to put the person down. So this samura who is being rejected is saying that, Ya Rasulullah, you've permitted Rafi to go and join the fight. But if I should fight with Rafi, I would definitely put him down. So that means I'm stronger than Rafi. So I should be allowed to go. I am even the most deserving to go. Okay. فَأَمَرَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ سَمُرَتَ وَرَافِعًا بِالْمُصَارَعَ The verbal noun. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Samura and Rafi to do Musara'a. Now Musara'a here, you know, even in culture, some culture, there is this thing that men will come and be struggling with each other who put the other down. This is what we also call Musara'a. It's also, so two men will be standing there, not really beating each other, not fighting, but struggling to see who will be able to put who down. We call it Musara'a. So that is what Rafi was, Samura was talking about. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them that field, that you both should put on this game. Let's see who goes down. And then he says, Fasara'a Samuratu. So look at it. Samuratu with the Dhamma here is the one who is doing the action of Sara'a. So he is the one who won. He is the one who put the other down. Fasara'a Samuratu Rafi'an. So you see Rafi'an also comes with the fathatain here, showing that it is the object. If you don't understand this, fa'il maf'ulun bihi, fi'il fa'il maf'ulun bihi, the verb, the doer, and the object option, please go to our An-Nahl Wadi lessons, the grammar lessons, and check the topic al-jumla, check the lesson jumla al-fi'liyya. Jumlatun fi'liyatun. Check this topic, you will understand all this. So the one with Dhamma is the one doing the action, and the one with Fatha is the recipient. So Samura defeated or put Rafi down. Kama qala, as he had said. Was tahaqqa, and he deserved, and yusmaha lahu, for him to be permitted. Samaha, to permit. And yusmaha lahu bidukhuli fi saffil mujahideen. And so he deserved to be allowed to enter into the row, arrow, into the rows, or into the assemblies of the mujahideen, those who are going out for the fight. So he deserved to be given a position in the row with men. Okay. Fa'ajaza, as I've already told you, the verb ajazta is from ajaza. So ajaza Rasulullah samurata. Here again, Fatha, and the Rasulullah doing the permission, doing the passing is the one with the Dhamma. Samura being the one receiving is the Fatha. So, فَأَجَازَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ سَمُرَةَ لِلْخُرُوجِ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam permitted Samura to go out with them. فَخَرَجَ سَمُرَةُ وَقَاتَلَ يَوْمَ أُحُدٍ So, Samura went out, وَقَاتَلَ, and he fought يَوْمَ أُحُدٍ on the day of Uhud. That is the day they fought the Ghazwat Uhud. Fi sabilillah, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he ends it with radiyallahu an Rafi'in wa Samura. May Allah have mercy on Rafi and Samura. Wa razaqana ittiba'ahuma, and bless us with the ability to follow them. Okay, here there is something I forgot to say. All this while, Samura is not taking Tanween. If you've looked at it very well, just Dhamma, just Fatha. The reason being that Samura is the name of a man, but it is Mu'annas. It is having the feminine symbol. Such names are Mamnoon min as-sarf. They do not take Tanween. That is what we call Mamnoon min as-sarf. Like names like Hamza. See Hamzata, Hamzatu. You see Hamzatun, Hamzatan. Like that, the name. Okay, so that is that with this particular topic. Anything that is unclear, please feel free to ask. We will have the time to answer for you, inshallah. Okay, so this brings us to the end of this Al-Haninu ila Shahadati part 2. Let's check if you have another Al-Hanin. Okay, the next lesson 40 in the book is Kun Ahada Sab'ati. We are done with the Al-Hanin series, part 1 and 2. Okay, may Allah bless whatever you've studied here. And please put it into practice. Put whatever you've taken here into practice. Whenever you are not clear how to use something, please do well to ask. I'm very conscious of comments and everything on the channel. So whenever you comment, you say something in the description section, you say something in the comments box, inshallah, I'll do well to respond to you. So if anything is unclear, you do well and contact me, whether through my mail or through here, I will clarify it for you. Our aim is to get a proficient, to be the proficiency of the language. So let's not let any opportunity slip away. Okay. With this, we come to the end of this lesson, inshallah. Till we meet again in lesson 40. Have a nice Arabic time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu.